Okay guys, so we are going to start our last topic for the CNC technology. And in these topics, I will be sharing you some of the trends. So when we talk about trends and technological developments, okay, we see that now currently with the coming and with the advent of CNC technology, new things are coming up. They are now getting integrated with the new systems, new machine learning, artificial intelligence, etc. So these are some things which are coming up nowadays in the current CNC technological development and trends. So what are those trends, and how do we see CNC system based on those trends? Let's take a start. So CNC technological trends. So in the background you can see that these are the companies which are CNC or NC developers. These are the machine companies that are very famous, and they are currently in the process of integrating new and latest systems in CNC technology. Okay, so when we talk about G&M codes, now there is a process to basically change the G&M codes to STEP NC, or Standard for Exchange Product Model Data. Now people are trying to change G&M codes to a new and easy machine language learning. I can see myself also, sometimes I am getting confused which code to apply, G01, G02, G03. It's a little bit tricky. So what happens is that you get confused, and the machine operator who have a lot of experience also, sometimes they are also in trouble. So for creating complex parts and for creating complex geometries, people are moving towards a new or relatively newer system, which is STEP NC technology. This is one of the trend. Now with the before Corona or before COVID, previously the global CNC market was very good. Companies like Delta, Fanuc, Haas Automation, Mitsubishi and Siemens were getting superb orders and superb global growth. And you can see in America, in Europe and in Southeast Asia, the growth rate was almost more or less the same. Here you can see in 2016 as well, that CNC technology was used in machine tool, semiconductor packaging, other handling systems, and in other industries. So they are relatively mixed when it comes to the ratio by which the growth is increasing. If you take a look at the global market distribution, then milling and turning are accounting to around about 70% of the machine tool or machining process which are being carried out. So what you have learned in the class is more or less about milling and drilling. Okay, milling and drilling contributes to around about 60% of the machining. So altogether, drilling, milling and turning are contributing to around about 90% of the machine process which is being carried out to create and manufacture parts. When we talk about the success or growth rate, then CAGR basically is a term, compound annual growth rate, CAGR. This is the rate of return that would be required for an investment to grow. It is based on the formula that the beginning value of the product and the final value of the product, these are two commodities. So based on this, how much is the percentage profit or annual growth can be perceived? So when we talk about machining and CNC technology, then we need to see what is the CAGR value of the CNC technology. So the CAGR value of the CNC technology is for Southeast Asia is growing very, very quickly. It's around about 44.8%. It means that CNC technologies is one of the technology which is coming up very quickly in Southeast Asia, and in other European countries, it because it is already saturated and it has developed, it's not coming up that fast. And where is this growth targeted? This growth is targeted towards automotive, electrical, machinery and other sectors. So among all the end use applications, the automotive and transportation segment is estimated to account to about nearly one third of the overall value of the opportunity created across the forecasted duration. So their forecasted duration is 2020 to 2030. So it means that the CNC technology, numeric control technology, has a very good prospect for the next 10 years as well. So those people who are working in this sector have good chances of growth as well. Next. Now Corona came. So what is the impact of Corona and COVID on CNC and machine tool market? So what has happened is that it has severely impacted the machine tools imports and exports. However, because of resilience, because of the companies who have done very good profits in the previous year, they still have got good risk analysis and they are still competing. There are some good companies which have not even taken the impact of COVID. So DMG, Okuma, and Japanese corporations such as Komatsu are the ones who are doing recovery at this stage. Next, we move on to 2010 to 2020 machine tool output. So as you can see that the output was increasing for 2010 to 2020. However, post-COVID, what happened? What happened in the United States in the last 30 days when it was 2020 April was that the total utilization of the CNC technology decreased. Similarly, the 70 moving average, if you see for US, okay, all the for 2020 there has been a significant decrease in the CNC system. The more there is a decrease, the more there is a chances that after the recovery it will increase. Okay, so it means that initially throughout the year there is a significant amount of orders, and then as the year progresses, the amount of orders decrease as well. And with respect to the number of years 2018, 19, and 20, the outlook remains almost a bit same. However, for 2020, due to COVID, the production utilization has decreased as well. So if you want to download these trends and if you want to go and see, okay, what is the outlook of the industry, you guys will have to download these expensive reports which cost around $5,400. So it's not easy for anybody to access the trends and current developments. These are a major part of economic growths, which are basically studied by the think tanks. And then what happens is that they put their findings in very expensive reports. So if you're looking forward to see what is the outlook of global machine tools, then you will have to pay around about $5,400. Next, what are the major key players when it comes to CNC technology? Some of them are written, Fanuc, Siemens. These are the companies which are making CNC controllers. Okay. So if you take a look at global CNC controllers, now they are looking forward to create five axis or even multi-axis CNC machining system. So these were some of the trends which have been set up or which the industry wants to move on. Next is what are the latest CNC technologies? What is going on currently? Okay, what is something? How is CNC evolving? So the first thing which comes to mind is that how the current information technology is impacting our technology, CNC technology, how computer science and mechanical engineering or manufacturing engineering is going to integrate together. So the best way for them to integrate together is the implementation of computerized systems, the latest Internet of Things, machine learning, artificial intelligence, embedded systems, sensors, actuators, etc. These are the things which are required to be applied to our mechanical and manufacturing systems. Only then only we can realize the impact and true potential of IT with respect to or combined with manufacturing. So I will open a video for you.
This is Jim. He is a manufacturer and owns a manufacturing plant. His plant has many things at one place, such as a supply chain and chain in the back office. All these things generate lots and lots of data, like transactional data, ERP data, CRM data, and public data. These are all the things together which empower and enable his employees to connect with customers and business partners. Now, even though Jim's factory looks well equipped, he still faces several challenges. During the production process, machines stop working frequently without any notice. Or sometimes the control system gets many errors at the time of product manufacturing. Even when Jim gets a lot of data, he cannot use it to predict the outcomes he wants. So, what could be the solution for Jim's problems? SoftWeb's IoT solutions are the best option for Jim to overcome these challenges. Whether it's a machine failure, problems in control systems, or getting accurate results from the data. Let's see how these IoT solutions can help Jim and his team. The Internet of Things, IoT, starts with the things installed in the manufacturing plant, the things that matter most to his business. The first step is adding sensors throughout the factory. In this production unit, IoT systems can help in monitoring production flow in real time to eliminate waste and unnecessary work in inventory production with the help of the sensors installed in the conveyor belt. All the data gathered by the sensors is sent to the cloud for analysis and creating predictive models. Not only this, but it will help engineers in implementing condition-based maintenance alerts to eliminate machine downtime and increase output by predicting machine failure. IoT can also help management to manage machines remotely, knowing temperature limits and other settings to save energy and reduce costs. With the collected data from sensors, operations managers can see their production line status and recommend adjustments to manage operational costs using data visualization tools. The R&D department can get insights from the usage patterns of multiple clients and track their equipment failure, enabling Jim's company to re-engineer products for better performance. On the other side, his field service management can identify when to deploy the right resources for predictive maintenance to minimize equipment failures and reduce service costs. With all these solutions, Jim can now tap into data with IoT dashboards and uncover actionable intelligence. He can also modernize how he does his business. IoT is a combination of sensors, cloud infrastructure, data analytics, and visualizations that helps you create a smart manufacturing unit.
Same is the case for machine learning. Machine learning is basically a subpart of artificial intelligence in which we take the data from the machine, analyze it, and then help to solve the problems of the machine itself by feeding some algorithm which will help the machine solve its own problems and take actions immediately or give us the recommended actions that can be taken. So machine learning is also a part of Internet of Technology, IoT, Internet of Things. So here is an example of implemented IoT system for a manufacturing industry. This is powered by IBM technology. Okay, in this IoT system, you can see that you have plant manager, you have got line operator, and you have got fleet management. Okay. If you see here, you can see that you've got six lines, line 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then line 6 is completely disabled. You can see line 1 has got two machines, okay, green shows that the line is working very correctly at a very good efficiency, then yellow shows it is working at a reduced efficiency, and red means that it is working at a critical efficiency. Then you have got overall effectiveness of the equipment, OEE, which is currently at 41%. We have the downtime average. These are some things which are directly given to you as a part of Internet of Things IoT system, okay. And how many orders have been achieved? So out of 1,392, until now 1,136 orders have been achieved. So if you're going to click OEE or overall equipment utilization, then you can see that it has been less than 8% in the past 3 days, and we are getting 5% less than the targets. So these are the cumulative KPIs which can be generated directly from the IoT manufacturing system. If you can see here overall equipment effectiveness, then here you can see the machines, what is the downtime, what is the hourly rate, okay, what is the faults which is coming up. So there is machine jam fault which is coming up too much, okay. There is empty magazine, door 2 is open. So these are some of the faults which are coming up, and they are reducing the downtime, okay. You can see the downtime KPI as well. This has been mentioned here as well. The downtime KPI can be observed, and these are some of the major reasons because of which the downtime is coming. So these are some of the indicators that you are getting directly at the tip of your fingerprints on your smartphone, on your computers. Next, we see the order count, whether we are achieving the overall KPI. So it looks like the weekly deficit has been 577 orders. Today's deficit might be 3 because of the fact that the machines are not operating at the correct efficiency. So the artificial intelligence based IoT things is going to predict whether you're going to complete your orders, etc. as well, based on its algorithms. Next, if you go to the operations or fleet management, then it is also going to give you what is the outlook of your fleets, what is the delivery time deliveries, what is the current status of each and every single thing. So every single thing now is automated and it is based on AI and IoT systems which can be implemented, and that is where we are moving towards smart industries or what you call smart systems. So how the question is, how do these technologies are helping CNC innovation? Okay, so IoT or Internet of Things is basically one of the factors because of which CNC technology can be improved. How you can monitor whether the machine vibration level are exceeding or not. You can monitor how much is the production rate that you can get. You can monitor how much is the power requirement, how much is the equipment downtime, and you can detect which parts of your machine are moving towards end of lifetime so that you can order their replacement in time. And the order takes place directly as well through AI technology. Next is how it can help us that with IoT and with these things, we can do greater parts complexity, okay? We can get more accurate and precision. Nowadays, with the current precisionness, we can get turning accuracy of 1 to 2 micrometer. This is almost equal to, how precise is this? This is equal to human red blood cell, because human red blood cell is 0.7 micrometer. So at cellular level also, we can have extreme efficiency. Next, the rise of multi-axis machining systems. So now we are moving and approaching towards machining systems in which you not we have 1 axis, 2 axis, 3 axis, but we are moving towards 5 axis machining center. What is this 5 axis? With the advent of 5-axis machining, we can now get very complex shapes and products, such as what you saw in the video was basically an impeller, pump impeller. So these are some of the technological advancements which are coming up for CNC system and CNC machining. and these are the technological advancements that you are going to observe for all the topics of manufacturing. What I will be teaching in rapid prototyping also, IoT is going in rapid prototyping also, IoT is going into laser welding also, IoT is going into casting also. Each and every single thing will be integrated and embedded with IoT and machine learning systems, okay?